Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 4.3, Problem 3. This is Section 4.3, Problem number 3. It says, a researcher compared the data for the number of active Facebook subscribers and the amount of debt in Greece. This is interest rate on a 10-year Greek government bond since 2005. And there was a linear correlation coefficient of R equal to 0.874. So, part A, which of these could be the graph of some of the data? Circle the correct graph. So we have two choices. And the difference is, as we go from left to right on the first one, the data points tend to go up. As we go from left to right on the second one, the data points tend to go down. Now, since the value of our correlation coefficient is positive, that would indicate that the data points should go up as we go from left to right. So the graph that could be the graph of some of the data is the first one. And again, because of the positive value of R and the fact that the points go up as we go from left to right. B. Can the number of Facebook subscribers be used to accurately predict the amount of debt in Greece? The answer is yes. Because this number is fairly close to 1, it means we can get an accurate and reliable prediction from that y equals a plus bx equation, the linear regression equation. This is telling me I can get a good, reliable prediction. So the answer is yes. So if we track the amount of Facebook use, we can pretty accurately predict the amount of debt in Greece. Now, part C, does this mean that Facebook use caused the Greek debt? No. So strong correlation only indicates that you can make accurate and reliable predictions. It does not prove cause and effect one way or the other. You may have cause. Maybe there's some weird connection that really shows that Facebook use is causing the debt. That's unlikely. But the bottom line is, just because you can make an accurate prediction doesn't mean one way or the other whether you have cause and effect or not.